I think that's worth some applause.
Thank you again for this very kind introduction. The idea behind the Young Physicist Tournament has a long history. Although the first IYPT, the international tournament, was launched in 1988, there was already a competition with the same name and with the same features that was running in 1979. And when the history is bright and detailed, it's always very interesting to know more about this history and to know the factual details like results, problems, regulations, schedule, and typical research solutions. Let me give you a few examples. The logo that we commonly use today was hand-drawn in 1981, first published in 1982, and appeared in the version that we commonly use today in the year 1990, and it's seen on the documents from that time. Still we don't know much about the competitions in the early 1980s. Some of them were developed up to the level that was quite sufficient to be submitted to journals, and at that time it was already the tournament solutions that were published in German. I need to make a little remark. Of course, everything was happening in the Soviet Union behind the Iron Curtain. You can see some examples. In 1988, exactly, at the first IYPT, there was already a team that made an numerical simulation and report to model gravitational waves on water, and they were using a very nice machine which was equipped with 1.77 megahertz CPU and 32 kilobytes of RAM. And of course at that time it was really impressive to their competitors. In 1989, the IOC, the International Organizing Committee of the Tournament, was formally and officially established, and of course that meeting ended up with minutes. It was a document printed in Russian language, the mechanical typewriter, and it included quite well-articulated statements and decisions about the IYPT, and some of them in principle are the one that we use today. And this is quite an impressive document. In 1992, the Dutch team was similarly the first team who brought the laptop to enhance the visual aids. Of course, there was no beamers at that time, so there was a laptop with a transparent LCD panel that had to be placed over the overhead, and like that the slides could have been projected to the screen. By that time, that was a major breakthrough, because most teams at the time period were using handwritten paper posters during the report. So you go to a tournament, you make a huge sheet of paper, you put some equations in your graphs, on this poster, of course without any plotters or any other equipment, and you show it. Where we know these details from? We know these details from sources. This includes articles, documents, handwritten notes, books, many other materials, including audio and video recordings. The sources are an extremely interesting source of information. But first, they were not available anywhere, and then even if you apply some efforts and you find a source, it's not evident that it will be complete and coherent. Let me give you an example here. You want to have a look at problem number 15 and the second IYPT. You find a text that was available to the participants, and you discover that the text is simply not complete. You look for more sources, it's here, and you discover that the points that were missing in the initial text, they were simply written differently across the sources. You should really apply efforts to restore the correct and reliable results. Sometimes the details are not only missing, but they read differently across sources published in different times by different people. That's why a reconstruction may seem to be necessary. So how the archive is working? We collect sources. They come from private collections, from authors, from editors, from institutional archives, sometimes from libraries, and when we have a huge collection of sources, now we have over 400 items that cover each year from 1979 onwards, with articles, documents, interviews, photos, videos, in different languages, then we can do some reliable reconstructions and translations into English to enhance the historical portfolio of the IYPT and make the history look really transparent and coherent. Looking for historical information is nice, but permanency keeping is also important, so future, so that in the future the details about the today's IYPTs are not lost. In 2007, Europe reported already a problem of data loss. When problems are lost, web pages are discontinued. And this is really a problem for a computation like IYPT. To give an example, a lot of original local web pages that were launched around 10 years ago are no longer available. And the team is now applying great efforts to back up the recent web pages. When we have enough information, we can have a look at the IYPT in the long run and notice some trends. For example, the theoretical problems were gradually shifted or phased out from the tournament, or the stage performance was gradually made longer time. So the report is only 5 minutes for a report at the first IYPT. So if you're interested in any of these details and you want to have a look at the problems, at the videos, at the recordings, at different materials and different sources, welcome to the IYPT Archive, which is up and running as of today. I wish you all a very pleasant competition here in Leoben, and best of luck. Thank you.